Good morning, class. Good morning, everyone. My name once again is Afolabi Abiola. So this morning we are to discuss a topic once again that is economics. The other time we discussed about what is economics. I said economics is an applied field of study that allows for the systematic and rigorous examination of the problem faced in promoting health for all. So that was the introductory aspect. And we also discussed about concepts of the economics, that is concept of health economics. So we said health economics is concerned with the utilization of limited resources, that is human and financial resources, etc., to cover all the treatment and intervention that improve the health of a society. So we also talk about capacity of these resources. That is, during that discussion, we talk about what goods and services shall we provide, how shall we provide them, then who shall receive them as well. So we also talk about the input. So we also talk about demand for healthcare. That is, healthcare is not usually demanded because it is pleasurable. In fact, it may be unpleasant. It is demanded mainly to improve health. So we also discuss about health market. We also discuss about some key points. The demand for healthcare is virtually unlimited, but supply is. So after that, I gave an assignment. So for the purpose of those that are not with us that very day. So this is the assignment once again. I said enumerate the factors that distinguish economics. That is number one. Number two, what is economic evaluation? Then number three, explain disparity in health or health care that are systemic and avoidable. I said you have to submit to thepurpleminute@gmail.com. So please, when you are submitting, make sure you give your detail, your detail identification, your location, your center, so that during submission we'll be able to know. So we also discussed about economic evaluation in healthcare. We said economic evaluation is closely related to health economy. Economic evaluation generates evidence-based information mainly through cost-effectiveness analysis or cost-benefit analysis to assist and improve decision-making of allocating healthcare resources. So we've also discussed this one. So the other day we stopped at allocation of healthcare resources. What are the allocation? What are the resources? How are they allocated for the maximum benefit of those seeking for healthcare? So, allocation of healthcare resources. Resources allocation is the distribution of resources, usually financial resources, among competing groups of people or programs. Allocation of funds for healthcare requires consideration at three distinct levels of decision making. That is, one, allocating resources to healthcare versus other social needs. That is one. Then two, allocation of resources within the healthcare sector. Then number three, allocating resources among individual patients. So these are the three distinct levels at making a decision or arriving at a conclusion when allocating resources. Then the allocation of healthcare resources has always been a controversial issue. Since the introduction of the National Healthcare Service, there has been a basic problem that resources are limited and demand cannot be met. Why is resources allocation needed? Yeah. Resources allocation are needed because of the increasing demand for healthcare services and rising costs to provide those services. That is, why do we need to allocate resources? Why not just earmark whatever that is available to the particular sector? Because the resources are limited and the demand for healthcare are increasing day by day. So therefore, there is the urgent need to allocate the resources in order to meet the demand of the people. So healthcare resources are defined. That is, what are the resources we are talking about? Healthcare resources are defined as all materials, personnel, facilities, funds, and other things that can be used for providing healthcare services. Healthcare is a limited resource for which there has been an unlimited demand for. Everyone needs healthcare. Thus, the need to properly allocate resources to healthcare services. The question which always been asked is the allocation of healthcare resources efficient, and is the allocation equitable? These are the frequent questions that people normally ask. So healthcare and government agencies must decide how to allocate their resources for a wide range of very different healthcare interventions. This involves making difficult judgments regarding the importance of certain health states. A number of arguments have been proposed in terms of need for healthcare or rights to treatment. The only fair way of resources allocation is to have two levels of organization. That is, the first one, based on the existing government structure, should be responsible for making broad decisions, such as the amount of money allocated to healthcare. Then the second level, made up of community organizations with membership, represent a wide range of healthcare related people who will be involved in making a policy decision and development of guidelines. So healthcare is limited by the total amount of resources available, as well as through competition with other areas, such as housing and agriculture. And it is difficult to determine who should be responsible for the rating of healthcare. That is, healthcare is limited by the total amount of resources available. And you know, when we are talking of each sector, other sectors are equally important. So, and at the end of the day, health sector will compete with other sectors such as housing, education, agriculture, and some other sectors like that to determine the exact allocation that will be allocated, or the exact resources that will be allocated to health sector at the end of the day. When rating of resources become necessary, some procedure has to be set up to allow the most appropriate allocation. This was the basis for the introduction of utility of cost utility analysis. There are three main theories which have been proposed to assist the allocation of resources, that is, the utilitarian theory, which argues that healthcare should be distributed so as to maximize the health of society, e.g., increase life expectancy, then reduction in infant mortality, without regard to how that good is actually distributed. Then the second one is the egalitarian theory. Egalitarian theory, which is based on the concept that everyone has a claim to the amount of healthcare resources, which gives them a level of health equal to that of others. That is the egalitarian theory. It is based on the concept that everyone has a claim to the amount of healthcare resources, which gives them a level of equal right to the others. Then the third one is Russian theory, which proposed that each person has an equal right to the system, and when making social and economic choices, those who are least advantaged should have maximum benefit. Although none of these theories is without fault, however, they may aid the development of guidelines. So we now move to method of economic evaluation. Method of economic evaluation include one, cost minimization analysis. This form of analysis is used when the outcomes of two procedures being compared are identical, and it is important the outcomes of the alternative program are proven to be the same if the method is used. The aim is usually to find the lowest cost programs, and the unit of measurement is per intervention. That is, when using cost minimization analysis, you want to make sure that you find the lowest cost program, and the unit per measurement as per the intervention of such program. So this is what we mean by cost minimization analysis. That is, you minimize cost to the barest minimum, and at the same time, you get the desired result. Then the second one is cost effectiveness analysis. Cost effectiveness analysis was the most widely used method of economic analysis before. It answers the question given, that has been decided, that is the type of healthcare will be provided. What is the best way of doing so? These are some of the questions that cost effective analysis answered. This method is used when the programs may have differential success in outcome as well as differential cost, but the outcome must be common to both programs, e.g., life years gain, then blood pressure reduction. Although it is not the cheapest per se, the aim is to find the most efficient treatment option in terms of cost per unit effect. A major disadvantage of the cost effectiveness approach is that it cannot be used to assess a single program or to compare intervention. We have different clinical effects. So that's one of the major advantages. So then the third one, cost benefit analysis. If the outcome of two health programs differs, then the common denominator must be established to allow for comparison of outcomes. One way doing this is to monitor time and cost benefit analysis aim to measure the cost of the cost of the consequences in terms of currency. Currency such as naira, pounds, dollar, euro, rupees, etc. It is a difficult concept because placing a monetary value on life or relief of suffering is a concept which many find difficult. That is, this is the disadvantage of this one again, because it's a difficult concept because people normally find it difficult to place monetary value on life or relief of suffering of a patient. So this is another advantage of that. Then the fourth one, cost utility analysis. Utility refers to the value or worth of a particular health state or an improvement in that health state. Utility values lie between 0 and 1, where 0 is equivalent to death and 1 is equivalent to perfect health. Cost utility analysis should be the method of choice when quality of life is an important outcome. It is also the ideal method when intervention affects both morbidity and mortality, or treatment have a wide range of different outcomes and a common unit is required. Utility-based measures are usually expressed in terms of quality-adjusted life years gain, that is QALY, quality-adjusted life years gain, which are calculated by multiplying the change in utility value as a result of medical intervention by the years of life in. The cost per quality adjusted life years is then calculated, that is QALY, is then calculated, and this can be used to produce league tables, which list intervention in order of cost per QALY. These funds may be used to guide resources allocation, that is, resources allocation in the healthcare industry. However, only by improving research in economic evaluation and by improving planning and management system will the health service progress. It is becoming increasingly obvious that demand for treatment cannot be good, and that choices need to be made. Alongside, governments and third-party payers have intensified their search for better value for money. It is equally important that all those individuals in the provision and purchasing of health care have a full understanding of the method in current use. Also, an increasing number of clinicians are likely to be involved in this field of research and will be required to have the knowledge of the technique being used. That is, have, at the end of the day, to have the desired results as regards economic evaluation in net economics, we can achieve this. At least we can improve on the and at the same time consolidate on the present gains by improving research in economic evaluation and also by improving planning and management system in health service programs. So it is also to be noted that it is becoming increasingly obvious that demand for treatment cannot be met and that choices need to be made. So if we are able to realize this, we will be able to make more impact along the line. And at the same time, government and third party payers, they have also intensified their search for better value for money. So it is as well, it is equally important that all those individuals in the provision and purchasing of healthcare have a full understanding of the method in current use. And at the same time, the clinicians, members of the technocrats in the health sector, they are likely to be involved in the field of research, and they will be required to have the basic knowledge of the technique being used. So these are some of the ways forward. After that, we'll be moving to Nigeria health care system or Nigeria health system. So before I go to that, I want to briefly tell us that health economics, as far as this program is concerned, at the end of the day, we should be able to know some of the points that I want to say now. That is, at the end of the day, we should be able to know the sources of healthcare financing in Nigeria and its challenges. And at the same time, we should be able to know the demand for healthcare and how does the supply and demand affect healthcare. That is, demand for healthcare. And you know, when we are talking of healthcare, we can also talk of demand and supply. So since healthcare is now being related as goods and services. So, and at the same time, we should be able to know the importance of economic evaluation in healthcare. And at the same time, we should be able to determine the factors that determine the demand for healthcare services. So these are some of the things that we should be able to know and identify ourselves at the end of this program. Then we now move to Nigeria health system. Healthcare provision in Nigeria is a concurrent responsibility of the three tiers of government in the country. That is, healthcare provision in Nigeria is on the concurrent list. We have some responsibilities that are on the exclusive list. Meanwhile, healthcare is on the concurrent legislative list. So that is why they say healthcare provision in Nigeria is a concurrent responsibility of the three tiers of government in the country. That is, private provider of healthcare have a visible role to play in healthcare delivery. And at the same time, the use of traditional medicine and complementary alternative medicine has also increased significantly over the past few years in Nigeria. So we now go to the health infrastructure. What are the health infrastructure? The health infrastructure, these are the infrastructure being put in place at the different sides of government. You know, we said healthcare in Nigeria is on the concurrent responsibility of the three sides of government. So from there, we should be able to deduce that the federal government role. So we define the federal government role, the state government role, and as well as the local government role as the third tier of government. So the federal government role is mostly limited to coordinating the affairs of the university teaching hospital, federal medical centers. That is, these are the tertiary healthcare facilities that we have in Nigeria. Teaching hospitals and the federal medical centers. While the state government manages the various general hospitals in the state, the state government also manages comprehensive health centers. So these are the infrastructures that are to be managed by the state government in Nigeria. While the local government focuses on maternities and dispensaries, that is the primary healthcare. You know, we have the tertiary healthcare for the federal government, the secondary healthcare for the state government, and the primary healthcare for the local government. So under the primary healthcare, we have maternities and dispensaries. So which are, and at the same time, these maternities and dispensaries are also being regulated by the federal government through the Federal Ministry of Health. There is an agency in the Federal Ministry of Health known as National Primary Healthcare Development Agency. So it is through this agency, that is NPHCDO, it is through this agency that activities at the primary healthcare are being monitored and tailored towards achieving their goals and objectives. So for as far as this the health economies is concerned, as far as this program is concerned, so this is the last topic we shall be dealing with. So, and we still have one lecture left. So before we go deep into this last lecture, I believe, well, after today, we still have one lecture. So before we go deep into this one, so let's quickly brush over some of the things we discussed the other time. Once again, let's start from health economics is used. It's also used to promote healthy lifestyle and positive health outcome through the study of healthcare provider, clinic, and public health promotion activity. Health economics is very important in determining how to improve health. Health economics uses economic concepts and methods to understand and explain how people make decisions regarding their health behavior and use in health care. It also provides a framework for thinking about how society should allocate its limited resources to meet people's demands the need for healthcare services. So this particular area, that is, health economics uses the economic concept and method to understand and explain how people make decisions regarding their health behavior and use in healthcare. It also provides a framework for thinking about how the society should allocate limited. So these are some of the key areas. Health economics provide a framework for thinking about how society should allocate its limited resources to meet the demand for healthcare need and health promotion and also its prevention. So this is a very key area. Then we also talk about concepts of economics. Health economics is concerned with the utilization of limited resources. So we should always have it at the back of our mind. If anytime we are talking about health economics, that health economics is concerned with the utilization of limited resources. Because if, assuming that the resources are in abundance, there is nobody that will be talking about health economics. So that is as a result of the fact that we have limited resources. That is why this concept of health economics is very, very useful. It's very, very necessary in the health economics. So an health economics is concerned with the utilization of limited resources, that is human resources, and at the same time, financial resources. So all these are the resources that are being allocated in health economics. So we now say to cover all the treatment and intervention that improve the health of a society. So the scarcity of these resources provide the formation of economic theory. And as such, three basic questions arise. What goods and services shall we provide? How shall we provide them? Who shall receive them? Then, health economics also addresses the question from the perspective of efficiency, maximizing the benefits from available resources. Then, equity concerns are also put into consideration. However, due to the contested nature of this area and the difficulties in qualifying equity dimension, this area has not been a major focus by health economics. Healthcare has always been an economic activity. Yes, like I said the other time, healthcare has always been an economic activity. People invest time, resources, needs. So, and the trade for it with each other. It is time. This amenable to economic analysis, understand the demand for it, its supply, its price relationship. Health economics also deal with both health and healthcare as a goods or services that is manufactured or produced. All production requires the use of resources such as raw material and labor, and we can regard production as a process by which these resources are transformed. So these are some of the things that we discussed earlier before, but due to the fact that we still have limited time, that's why I'm trying to refresh our memory about it. So, like I said before, our time will soon be up. We're having 4 minutes to go. So, and as far as this course is concerned, by the course outline, we deal with virtually all. So, the last one, which we've started, is one we'll be teaching in our last meeting as regards this course is concerned, that is health care system in Nigeria. So that is Nigerian health system or Nigerian healthcare system, be it as it may. So this is going to be our last topic of discussion. as far as the program is concerned, I think health economics. So, by the grace of God, when next we meet, we'll finish it once and for all. So, and there, praying for our exams. So I wish each and every one of us the best of luck. I pray that we all pass our exams. I pray that we all come out in flying colors. So once again, I'm Afolabi Abiola by name. I'm saying to when next we meet, make sure you stay safe. Make sure you adhere strictly to all the hygienic rules as prescribed by the NCDC. Wash your hands regularly, cover your nose, ensure physical or social distance, and some other things as prescribed by the NCDC. So, see when we meet, I say thank you and God bless.